Students will discuss about the applications of total internal reflections. Applications of total internal reflections. That means the ray has to be reflected back. Let us first consider what is the critical angle for glass air, normal glass air surface. Critical angle for glass air. Suppose we have a glass plate here and light travels from this glass plate and move outward, and if the ray grazes the surface, this is a glass, outside it is air. Now this is angle is 90 degree, so this angle of incidence for which this refracted angle of refraction is 90 degree, this angle is called critical angle. See, now we also know that the refractive index of this glass is, suppose that it is refractive index of a glass with respect to air is 3/2. Not all glasses they have the same value, but mostly it is 3/2, that is 1.5. Crown glass and that refractive index is different from other glass. So now let us find that if this glass has refractive index 1.5 and what is the critical angle? Means what angle the ray should strike the surface or must come out of the denser medium? With what angle of incidence the ray should strike the or come out or strike the surface of air so that the refracted ray moves along this line? That angle we have to find. So this is the critical angle, and we know that the sine of this angle is 1 by mu. Now mu is denser with respect to denser medium. So this is 1 upon mu is denser, this is denser, and this is denser medium, so we can put 3/2. So this becomes 2/3. Sine c is 2/3, this is absolutely correct because sine c cannot be greater than 1. In any case, if you are confused with putting these values here, you can just write whatever is written here. We are not concerned about that. You can never write 3/2 here because that will be greater than 1. So sine theta cannot be greater than 1. Sine theta value is always from plus 1 to minus 1. So the theta always lies between plus 1 and minus 1. Maximum, so it cannot be greater than 1. So here 3/2 is greater than 1, so that you cannot write. So this is 0.6 something, it's okay. So from here the 2/3, from here the c equals to sine inverse of 2/3, this comes out to be nearly 42 degrees. So critical angle of glass air interface is 42 degree. The light has to travel from glass to air, not from air to glass. This also means that if I for glass air, if I is greater than 42 degree, this angle, if is greater than 42 degree, say 43 degree, then the ray will be reflected back. That is for sure. Implies TIR. And the first condition that we have already met, that it is moving from glass to air, denser to air. So for this, As we already discussed, because we have to assume that this refractive index of this is 3 by 2 and refractive index of L is 1, because absolute refractive index, L refractive index is 1. Now, if I had to apply this isosceles right angle prism are used to turn a ray through 90 degree or 180 degree. This is one of the applications. We have a prism. Prism will discuss later on in detail. We have a prism. It's a glass prism. Prism when two light passes through two inclined planes, then that is a prism. That we'll discuss some other day, because prism is also there in this chapter. Now, to turn the ray by 90 degree, if ray of light is incident, so this is a isosceles triangle, the two sides of the center is 45-45, okay, this is 45, this is also 45, this angle is 90, okay, the light strikes normally to the first surface, this face, first surface, normally. In case of normal incidence, we have already discussed, in case of normal incidence, the ray undergoes without any deviation. So this is 90, so there is no deviation, because in normal incidence, though this is glass, flint glass or crown glass, this will go straight. And here, suppose that this is the normal, this is the normal. Here, this is the normal. So this is a normal incidence, but for this case, this normal, this is the oblique incidence. For oblique incidence, this is the angle that we have to see. If this condition is met, if the angle is greater than 42, then only TIR, or you can reflect back, or otherwise it will emerge out. This is 90, so this will be 90. This is 45, so this will be 45. If this is 45, then this angle is also 45. That means the angle of incidence is 45, which is greater than 42. So, what is the case now? This angle is 45. If the angle of incidence is 45, then more than 42, the ray has to be reflected back. Okay? Since angle of incidence is 45 degree, which is greater than 42 degree, this means that total internal reflection. So the ray has to be reflected back, and it has to follow the law of reflection. From the law of reflection, the angle of incidence should be equal to angle of reflection. So this is 45, this should be 45, this will turn through 45. So this is 45, because this 45, this 45 is 90. So this is just like that. So this is 45, this is, should be 45 reflected ray, and if this is 45, this becomes 90, this goes like that. If this is 45, this should be 45, this angle is also 45, this is already 45, so this should be 90. That means it should come like this, perpendicular to this, and to this face, this ray is normal, so it is a normal incidence, so the ray goes straight without any deviations. So here normal incidence, here also coming out normal incidence, there is only a reflection here. So this way, you turn the ray by 90 degree. So this is how the ray was incident initially, and finally it goes like that. So this way, we are turning the ray by 90 degree. TIR is used. TIR is used to turn the ray by 90 degree or 180 degree. This is the example for turning the ray by 90 degree. We'll take one example where you can turn it by 180 degree. What will do? This ray has to be again turned back 90 degree in this direction. And this is the incident normal initial directions. and this is how you turn it by 90 degree, then again you turn it by 90 degree in this direction. So this incident ray and this final reflected ray is now 180 degree. Okay, so this is also possible. This is also done. How this is done? Now, let us draw a diagram to justify how that is done. Okay. This way, the ray is going to turn back. How it is done? As we have seen that this angle, this type of triangle is a equilateral triangle. All angles are 60 degree. This is 60, this is 60, this is 60. Now this would be 30. If this is 60, this would be 30, and this would be normal, and this would be 60. This angle is 60 degree. So the angle of incidence is greater than 42 here. So 60 is greater than 42. So this ray will get turned by 60 only, because angle of incidence is angle of refraction. This is 60. If this is 60, this is 30. Because this total angle should be 90 degree. If this is 30, then this is already 60, so this would be 90. So the ray should be 90 here. If it is 90, then it should go straight, but then it is not isosceles triangle. So this diagram is wrong. Okay, this diagram is wrong. Then what we'll do? We'll take this isosceles triangle, same isosceles triangle. This prism, I can let the ray fall in this direction, perpendicular to the surface, like this. Then this is 45 45, so this is 90, this is has to be 45, and this line is the normal. If this is 45, this has to be 45, so that angle is greater than 42, which is more than critical angle. So you this is reflected back in 45 degree, so this would be 90 degree. This is 45, so this would be 45, this is 90, this is 90 degree, most like that. Now if this is 45, this is 45, this is also 45, this angle is normal. This is 45, this also is 45, this is 45. And if the ray strikes like that, 45 degree with the normal, then it's again reflected back at 45. This is 45. If this is 45, this is already 45, this is 45, this has to be 90. This is 90. If this is 90, then it goes straight like that. So this is right. This is correct. And this diagram is wrong. So you have to draw your own diagram. The prism you have to choose correctly to bend the ray. So here the ray is bent. The ray is bent by 180 degree. This is the initial direction in which the ray was coming, and this is the final direction in which the ray is going out. So you can see that the incoming ray is in this direction, the outgoing ray is in this direction. So that is a reversal of 180 degree. Okay. Thank you.